But they want to take counsel of the philosophy that's floating around here in America. You know? That's what they dealing with. Go ahead, brother.
And that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit.
Yeah, they cover with a covering, but not of my not of Yahweh's spirit.
Right.
You know? They want to be under the vibration of Caesar Borgia. They want to be cloaked in democracy. I mean, you got so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that's out there that's drunk.
Right.
You know? That's drunk off the off Trump being the president. You got our people out there that's basically drunk off the covering of going in and being a part of this man's military. You know? You got some of these young Jakes that say, you know what? I wanna go vote for what's the name?
Bernie Sanders.
Yeah. Cause he gonna give us free funds for college.
Gifts.
And college is wicked.
Yep, God.
Right.
Cause ain't nothing righteous about college.
Right.
You got people setting up college funds for their children, man. Sending their children off to a cesspool of wickedness.
Right.
All you learn how to do in college is be a damn freak, man.
That's it.
A drug dealer.
Be a drug dealer. You got a lot of these young kids that go in to get in college. I'm talking about really our people. Them Edomites do it too, but they do it. They be on another level. They go get student loans and all this, and then they got they stand on campus based off of student loans, and they enroll for a semester. They not going to class. All they doing is partying and selling dope. You know what I'm saying? It's a wicked environment, man. Very, very wicked environment. So was it done in Isaiah 30?
Isaiah 30, starting at 1. Woe to the rebellious children, said Yahweh, that take counsel, but not of me. And that
and it's saying woe over here in Amos, and it's saying woe over here in Isaiah 30. So it's saying destruction. If you ain't about about the knowledge, the wisdom of this book, and applying it in your life, then woe on you. Destruction. You know? And it ain't all about just keeping the law. Now, don't get me wrong, we are for the law, but we understand being in these bodies, being in this flesh, and being in captivity, there's no way we can keep the law perfect. So it ain't all about just, I'm keeping all the law, statutes, and commandments, because that's impossible, and that's what's gonna get you up out of here.
Right.
If you're talking like that, you one of them guys that's not keeping the law, statutes, and commandments.
Right.
But I believe, I can't prove it, you know, I'm being funny about it, but I believe they really might believe over there in IUIC that just as long as they keep the fringes on, they cover. They keeping all the laws because, you know, the fringes is supposed to represent the laws, all the different laws, and remind us to keep them.
Right.
So I believe they believe, as long as they got fringes on their borders, they good. Because as soon as they see wild fringes, man, they gonna persecute you to the highest degree.
Oh,
yeah. If IUIC catch you without them fringes, man, that's a high penalty to pay, you know, dealing with them camps. All because of that dude Nate, but let's go ahead and finish that, all right?
And
then we'll come back to
And that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit.
Right. Jake don't want to have nothing to do with Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. That's why he called them rebellious.
Yep.
They warn against the Most High. The Most High even said, don't expect the children of Israel to listen to you, for they are not hearkening unto me. Unto the Most High. So of course, the children of Israel, two-thirds of them, they're not gonna get right because the prophets came out and said, hey, you the Israelites, come back to your nationality and keep the words of this book. they're going to say, get the hell out of here.
Right.
I got something better than you. Because that's basically what they said when they just walk on by. They said, you know what, the hell with that.
Yeah.
I'm trying to go search for the next wicked act I can commit.
Because
they might go right over here to Domino's Pizza and get a slice of pepperoni pizza. You just went and did some wicked, you know what I'm saying? Are you thinking about this man's wife you want to pop later on tonight because it's Saturday. Saturday's day, which this is a highly wicked day in Babylon. The most wickedness probably happened on this day.
Yeah.
On Saturday. You know what I'm saying? This is a party day, a day where you off work. A day I've been working all week. I finally get to,
That's Michael Jackson, huh?
Go ahead.
No, I ain't working. Off the wall.
Okay, yeah.
The song Off the Wall, you know? Gonna leave my 9-to-5 off the shelf.
Yeah,
right. For myself. You know what I'm saying? And living off the wall, man. See that, you know?
They got the song Living for the Weekend.
Right.
They can't wait. Friday they get paid. Saturday, you get paid on Friday, but you just got off of work.
Yeah.
You might can go out Friday night, you know, chill a little bit, but Saturday is when you done got you some rest in the day.
Yeah.
Now tonight, I'm going to do it big, and I got to get it in tonight because I got to go to church in the morning.
Yeah.
Right.
So,
hey, don't forget Ludacris, huh? Saturdays, huh?
Yeah.
A lot of wickedness. He's like, a lot of wickedness goes on.
Yeah, right. On Saturday, because that's when the clubs is open.
Everything popping.
You know, they got a little, basically that's when you're going to get into the club.
Yeah.
I heard the little weird ass song about in the club on Tuesday.
On Tuesday.
They're
going up.
You know, Friday is the prerequisite to Saturday.
Right.
You know, it preps you because you get off work, you got to get clean, go buy you some clothes or something.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it's a mild night of wickedness. See, we're wicked.
Yeah.
Then on Saturday, it's time to go whole day.
In.
No work from when you wake up to you pass out. Because you ain't going to sleep, you're passing out, you know, on some drugs.
Dope.
You know? But Saturday is probably the most wicked day of this calendar that Esau got set up. You know? And then on a Saturday, you talking about, something, keeping laws, you know, come back to my nationality. Nah, I'm trying to get loose tonight.
Because Saturday, that's the seventh day, ain't it? And they make it complete. Because, you know, contrary to popular belief, most people think, you know, Monday is the first day of the week. Shit, Sunday is the first day of the week. Saturday is the last day, which would be the seventh day. Seventh represents completion, man.
Yeah.
So it's a complete week of wickedness. Yeah. You're going to wrap it all up on that Saturday.
Yeah.
Right. It's Esau's day of completion.
Yeah.
And then to clean it up on Sunday.
Yeah, get right.
And then you're going to go worship the sun to clean it up. Nothing but madness going on here in America.
Oh.
You know? That goes into covering with the display Egypt's covering, because on Sunday, tomorrow morning, a lot of our people that they got doing all our wickedness throughout the week, and then especially on Saturday, they think they're gonna be cleaned up on Sunday. You know, just by stepping inside the Harlem House, listen to this pork chop eating pastor. You know. Tell them a bunch of words of hope.
Right.
You know?
Right.
False hope.
God.
We are prisoners of hope, but it's supposed to be a hope according to what's written in the book.
Right.
Not hoping I'm going to get a bigger and better house. Hoping I'm going to get a better job. I'm going to get more money. Hoping that my wife don't leave me and she give me some box tonight. You know? Go ahead,
back in Isaiah 30, that they may add sin to sin.
That they may, read the verse, the line above that real quick.
Okay. And that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit.
So it's telling you that when you cover with a covering that's not a Yahweh Ba Shem Yahweh Shah spirit, you're going to add sin upon sin in this place. Because no matter what you do, if it ain't in this kingdom, if you're not attached to this word in truth, Yeah. In truth, that is, you can't just say, oh, well, I read the Bible every day, and I learned from a nigga named Jim Brown. Or a nigga named Bishop McClendon.
Yeah.
You know? You know, you can't, that don't mean you right in Babylon. You gotta be, it don't mean you right while you living in Babylon unless you have the truth and applying this truth, you know, to you Israelite. No matter what you do, it's sin.
God.
If it ain't nothing righteous about waking up, going into that Harlan house under the banner of the 503 on Sunday morning, really worshiping the sun and eating pork chop sandwiches after the service.
Yeah.
You know?
System.
All right, go ahead, bro.
Isaiah 30, verse 2. That walk to go down into Egypt and have not asked at my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh and to trust in the shadow of Egypt.
Right, so instead of our people trusting in the Most High, they prefer to go to the so-called white man, which is Esau. Because they're talking about Pharaoh right here in Egypt, but that's just symbolic talk. The code talk about America and the so-called white, the modern-day pharaohs are Edomites. That's in rulership. That's in power.
No.
Go ahead. So whatever Esau has to say, because our word means nothing, but if Esau comes, like, for example, the Flat Earth Doctrine. Esau came with the Flat Earth Doctrine. That wasn't something that... Jake sat around and said, you know what, let me go and learn and study, and I understand that the earth is flat.
Right.
No, you got that because Esau put his camp on it.
That's right.
You know, so you want to go under Esau's cover. You know? Go ahead, Ari.
Isaiah 30, verse 3. Therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame.
Therefore shall, by you trusting in the so-called white man, it's saying Pharaoh, but it's talking about Esau, y'all going to be ashamed. It's going to come a point in time that our people going to be ashamed that they believe what's in this, all this madness, which this is what Egypt promotes.
That's right.
Homosexuality, that you believe and you are okay with, as long as, you know, the homosexuals stay away from me, I'm cool with them. I don't have no problem with them, as long as they don't come and meet with that. Well, they are, because they are coming at you with the homosexuality shit. Because what you think of going through a homosexual's mind when he look at another man?
Right.
He ain't looking at, he looking at you in a sexual way.
Sorry, Will.
You know? He really undressing you with his eyes. You imagine, you got punks walking up and down the street, man, and they undressing men with their eyes. The same way a man see a fine woman, he be like, "Godly," you know. And you can see through the. I wear in this kingdom, it's a little kingdom. So you know, everybody out here naked, even the men wearing tight, you know, tight jeans and stuff, you know. He just waiting on the wrong word to come out.
Yeah.
That was it, right?
No, I got it.
Okay, go ahead.
Isaiah 30, verse 3. Therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame, and the trust in the shadow of Egypt your confusion.
Yeah.
All right, read the last line again.
And the trust in the shadow of Egypt, your confusion.
And the trust in the shadow of Egypt. Shadow is representing rest.
Yeah.
So you want to rest in here in America.
Yeah.
Now, we don't get him off. You don't get it, Michael. So they want to trust. Rest in America.
Right.
They think they actually gonna get rest in here in America. We ain't gonna ever get no rest here in America. Even they have these top entertainers, athletes, actors, or people that just so-called got a good job here in America, they not sleeping well at night, man.
Wow.
Because, you know, they know For example, if say you're not an actor or entertainer, you're not making hundreds of thousands to millions, but you just got a good salary job, one of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and you might be making $80,000, $100,000, $120,000 a year, and you say financially you might be comfortable, but you know you gotta take the back seat to Esau at the job. You gotta take being belittled and tuck your nuts in around the so-called white man at your job. You're neutered. The white man neuters you on the job site. And that's what, you know, Esau do that with them. You know they do that with the lions, some of the lions, like, they actually, so that they don't have, you know, testosterone building up in them, they neuter them.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, man.
So that their aggression won't basically come up out of them. Like, that's why you see them. Man, if that was just an actual wild lion, y'all see, like, maybe in the zoo or you watch certain documentaries on the YouTube, and they show you them lions that's domesticated. They not acting.
Oh yeah, I see.
By the instinctive nature.
Yeah.
They acting
docile.
Yeah. Soft, docile. They run around playing. They ain't biting. Yeah. They grow up. They just want to fight and play and wrestle. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And get and hunt all day. All lions really do is eat, sleep, and hunt.
Yeah.
And they have sex. You know, with an alpha male. You know. They, you know, but anyway, that's what's spiritually happening to what's happened to our people. You know, they've been spiritually neutered. And then you basically gotta sell out. They don't even know that they're selling out. Cause I experienced it on a real low level. You gotta basically bow down and kiss this man's ass because if you wanna move up. You gotta follow these different guidelines the way he want it, and he over your back, and he just keep poking at you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? He wants you every time he poke you, you kiss on his,
right.
You know, on his backside. You know? And then these entertainers, they asking to get bent over, or give the elite the blood sacrifice. You know? So they not sleeping well at night, man.
Right. Yeah.
So money ain't gonna solve the problem, even if they think if they get rich. And even like the apostle Zohar brought out, if you did have millions and even if you didn't sell out, that's gonna get boring. You just you just keep doing the same thing.
Every day.
You can only go on so many trips, buy so many cars and watches and all that and get exhaust yourself in sex, you're gonna be like, damn, this is it. Because we're the Israelite, that is.
Right.
Because we what created to be upright. You know?
It's like me and the brother were talking about Esau sit around, he got all this money and stuff. Esau, he get his fill, but then that's not enough. It's not enough. I can pop all the women I want to pop. So let me get some little boys.
Right.
Let me pop them. And let's bring a couple of dogs in the room do whatever. They keep going. See, but like the brother say, we got to live it upright. We got all that. We got to keep it in the law, statutes, and commandments. You can only pop so many, you know. Everything on this side, man, it get boring, man.
Yeah, Esau, you know, this is kingdom. He's supposed to be resting.
Yeah.
And these other nations that have committed fornication with the whore. You know, they supposed to be enjoying it here too. But it ain't so enjoyable because this kingdom is going down.
That's right.
You know? These Edomites go rock climbing, skiing, jumping out of planes. They have an adventurous life in America. You know what I'm saying? One, you know, they get off on wickedness. Jake really don't. They getting off on Jake wicked, man. Because y'all getting off on wicked now because y'all have been up under this devil for so long. You know? But our people think that they can obtain rest right here in America.
All is
but there's no rest here, no matter what you do. Go ahead, I.
This is Micah chapter 2 and verse 10. Arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest.
Yeah, arise ye and depart, for this is not your rest. Talking about right here in America. We didn't. How that look, man? Our foreparents, which I'm not going to go all into the reincarnation, but our foreparents came over here And then you tribes, y'all was already the Latin, so-called Latin tribes, the Native American tribes, y'all were already on this side of the earth, or the hemisphere, before the Southern Kingdom got over here.